We are very focused on being kind to others, taking care of our responsibilities, doing what needs to be done, and doing all the right things, overworking, and feeling overwhelmed. What we forget in the process is self-compassion, being kind to yourself, which is the most important thing. If you're not okay, there is very little you can do to help another person. It's very important for us to remember that. So take timely breaks, ask for help. There is no ego in reaching out to your support system, be it your spouse, be it your children. Get all the help you can so that, when you need a break and you feel overwhelmed as a result of caregiving, which can be COVID, caregiving is a different league in itself. It also makes you question whether, you're actually caregiving in the sense that you're not allowed to go inside the room of isolation if your family is isolated inside your house, because, you shouldn't go near them. Those are the directives that we've been asked to follow. It can make you feel extremely guilty. This is something that has happened a lot, especially with women caregivers. We are very culturally, it's culturally ingrained in us to take physical care of a person who's not well in the house, fluff a pillow or check their temperatures and make them all kinds of things they like and physically feed them. And COVID does not allow you to do those things. Makes you feel like, oh my God, what is this caregiving I'm doing? I'm not even being fair. And is this how you take care of somebody? I mean, it's like this is not some jail that, you just give them food from outside and walk away. But that is what you need to do because that's the only way you can stay safe and you can protect the others in your family as well, knowing fully well that the person who's in isolation, the person you're taking care of, is okay, right? Obviously, you need to ensure over video calls or phone calls that they are self-monitoring. They're making sure that their SpO2 levels are checked, their fevers, they're keeping their fever in check. They're monitoring their own levels and letting you know. So what can you do? Make sure that you're in constant touch with them. Make sure that, the things that you need to do, you are asking them to do themselves without them feeling overwhelmed. And when you call them and you comfort them, they know that you are not asking them to fend for themselves. You're actually concerned about them. You care about them. It's just that situation circumstances are different. So that is one part of COVID caregiving that has been extremely challenging for all of us. You also need to cook separately a lot of times, the vessels, the food handling. Some of them have diet restrictions. You have to be very careful about those things. So that, along with the fear that has any other family member also been affected, all the what ifs that cross our mind, we can become afraid. We can start reacting to those, the difficult situation that we're dealing with right now. And that can be extremely disheartening and upsetting for us. So when, if and when you have a family member who's affected by COVID or affected by any other illness, along with COVID, then you have to make sure that you don't feel overwhelmed as a result of it. It's important that you stay positive so that the positive vibes go across to that person in your house who is unwell as well. If they see fear in your face, they hear fear in your voice, then they start feeling afraid. Even if things are not great, it's important for you to stay upbeat so that, the patient in your house feels that no, things are under control and they're going to be all right. A lot of times, the illness we deal with is a battle of the mind. And the weaker we feel, the more overwhelmed and anxious we become, our body starts responding accordingly as well. So, as a caregiver, take care of yourself so that you can take better care of those who require your support. Have a routine, make sure that you sleep and wake up at a certain time. Try to do a little bit of basic 5, 6 minutes of maybe breathing exercises, simple exercises. step out into the balcony, look outside, take in some fresh air, take in some, you know, if you have plants, then, you know, literally feel the flowers and the leaves and get in touch with as little nature as you have with, you know, the way COVID as an illness is being perceived and treated, and, you know, the biohazard aspect of, you know, simple things like trash coming from your house and is treated as biohazard. It makes you think that, oh my God, what is it that we are dealing with? And, you know, little things like those can be extremely overwhelming for you. So when that happens, it's important to talk about it to the others within your family, or reach out to a friend, or reach out to a therapist, reach out to the doctor. Ask the doctor, the treating doctor of your family member, to answer questions that worry you, that you're concerned about, so that, you know what to monitor, you know what to look out for in case things get worse for your family member, and you're prepared, right? Having emergency numbers in hand, and as much as possible, whenever possible, take a break. It's okay to sometimes not, you know, do everything. You know, learn what to worry about. Don't sweat the small stuff. Don't be compulsive about your house being a certain way, the food tasting a certain way. It's all right. Focus on the basics and focus on getting some rest yourself, and do not take in negative people or negative communication and negative information as much as you can. You have to be able to manage, somebody else better. Yeah, yourself first. Self-compassion and kindness is critical.